Last week, crews out in Callaway, Minnesota, have been working to fix the train tracks that were damaged when a semi-truck collided with a train last week, prompting an evacuation followed by a propane tank explosion that could be felt for miles.
Valley News Team's Cornelius Hocker tells us what Minnesota laws say about stopping a railroad crossings and also what one person who lives near the track in Callaway thinks needs to be done now to prevent future accidents.
The usual sound of train traffic in Callaway, Minnesota, has been replaced by the sound of crews working on fixing the damaged tracks. People who live in Callaway say it won't be long before train traffic picks back up, and they'd like to see something done to avoid any more collisions.
They do need to do railroad crossings there because it will happen probably a couple more times, if not sooner down the road.
Tyler Zitzo lives just feet away from the tracks in Callaway and says more signs will limit the excuses drivers have if another collision happens.
It comes down a lot to the truck driver. I mean, a lot of it's people, no cars have been hit. Everybody, cars have been fine coming through here. It's just the truck drivers that just get hit every time.
Minnesota statutes state clearly, everyone must stop at railroad crossings if a train is approaching. And if it's determined those statutes have been violated, the driver of the vehicle could face a misdemeanor charge.
Trains always have the right-of-way 100% of the time. So it's up to vehicles to make that decision, to look both ways and make sure that they can cross it safely.
The North Dakota Safety Council says laws giving trains the right-of-way are there for a reason.
Trains cannot stop quickly. The average freight train going 55 miles an hour can take a mile or more to stop.
A lot of it's common sense, but I mean, that only goes so far, too.
In Callaway, Minnesota, I'm Cornelius Hocker.
Becker County Sheriff's Office tells us the investigation into the collision is ongoing and can't tell us if the driver of the semi-truck will face charges. For more train safety tips, look for this story on our website at Valley.